Who here knows that we're living in strategic times? All right, 2018 is the year of Isaiah 8:18, where every single one of us, the children of God, are signs and wonders to this generation. Amen. Well, guess what? 70 years ago, it was the birthing or the reunification, the rebirthing of the state of Israel. We just celebrated the 70th year anniversary of Israel becoming a nation again, right? Well, guess what? Right around that same time, a little bit north from here in Battleford, Canada, what happened 70 years ago? It was a latter rain outpouring. Come on, somebody. It was a latter rain outpouring where there was a whole new move of the prophetic and as well as signs and wonders. That was 70 years ago, right at the same time in conjunction with Israel becoming a nation again. You guys follow me? Whenever Israel is blessed and the church is also blessed. Whenever Israel, the firstborn, is blessed and the fruits such as ourselves, we're also entering to a greater measure of that. Amen. Well, guess what? Around that same time, 1948, some people say 1949, Billy Graham started his evangelistic crusade in Los Angeles. Who here knows that LA is a city that has birthed, that has given birth to some of the greatest revivals in the world? Well, Billy Graham started his ministry, the evangelistic crusade. Most people say 1948 or 1949, but right around that time, now we see stadium Christianity. We see masses of souls that are coming to Jesus. We see masses of souls filling up the stadiums and these crusade-like evangelistic encounters where people are hearing about the gospel of Jesus Christ. Well, guess what? This year is the 70th year anniversary of Israel becoming a nation. This year is the 70th year anniversary of the latter rain outpouring in Canada. Come on, somebody. And guess what? This is the year where the great late evangelist Billy Graham has gone home to be with the Lord. All of these correlations are coming in line right now. Come on, somebody. All of these things are coming into line. Do we not see the signs of the times? So now, what are we expecting for? Now, what are we looking out for? We are expecting for the old 70-year cycle, which has just ended. We are now entering into a new 70-year cycle. We are entering into a new 70-year cycle. Is anybody hearing me right now? What happened when the prophet Daniel began to prophesy to the Israelites? They said, for 70 years, you will be held captive in Babylon, but afterwards, you will enter into a season of jubilee. I believe, church, we are entering into a season of jubilee, of liberation, where your land is going to be returned to you. Your finances are going to be returned to you. Your family members are returning to the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the season right now where God has just ended a 70-year cycle, and now we are in transition of a new cycle. Someone say amen. So let me ask you this. What does this mean? It means that we're entering into a greater measure of signs and wonders. All right. It means that we're entering into a whole new dimension of the prophetic. It means we are entering into a whole new level of mass stadium evangelism and souls coming to Jesus. Come on, somebody. And I believe every single one of us, we're here gathered right now. You may be in the business realm. You may be in the governmental realm. You may be in counseling. You may be in ministry. But I believe every single one of us, we're gathered here for one thing, because we're entering into a new cycle, believing for greater signs and wonders and sons and daughters to come into the kingdom of God. So praise God. Lift up your hands. I want to pray. Father, I thank you for every single person here. I thank you that not only will they have the strategy, but they will enter into their divine Kairos moment. They will enter into their divine Kairos faith, which is to win souls, which is to reach the lost, which is to birth the manifestation of Christ Jesus. And we say yes and amen to the new 70-year cycle that we, the church, are entering into. Greater signs and wonders and greater mass evangelism and greater miracles on the earth. In Jesus' name, we all say amen.